Hey everybody, so a few weeks back I got an interesting email in my inbox and it was inviting me to take a course on ASL, American Sign Language. And I was like, this is amazing, and it was offered to all Microsoft employees. And so I decided to do a little bit of digging and find out why we're offering these courses, how we're offering these courses, who gets to take these courses. So happily I found Jenny Leigh Fleury, who is the chair of the Disability Group here at Microsoft, and she's here to answer all of our questions. So first of all, thank you so much for coming down.
Thank you for inviting me.
So let's discuss, first of all, the disability group here at Microsoft. When was that established and how did you become involved?
Great question. So disability at Microsoft, we've been around now for about 5 years. There's always been different pockets of disability groups, folks for blindness, folks with deafness, and we came together and formed one employee resource group about 5 years ago with a sponsorship of diversity and inclusion.
And then how did you become the chair?
I became the chair. One, I helped to form it with the help of HR, and we have a great leadership team, and we all decided we all take different roles, whether it's chair of a group, and I'm the chairperson who brings them all together. So it was an agreement of the group, and
awesome.
I'm very, very honored to have that role.
Well, congratulations. So obviously one of the things you guys do is offer American Sign Language classes,
yeah.
And we'll talk about that in a minute, but what are some of the other things you guys do as a group?
So we're a group of really diverse people, right, with different backgrounds. Some people are employees with deafness, employees with disabilities, others are friends, others are parents. So we come from lots of different places. And we come together annually, internally, with a conference, the mm-hmm. Ability Summit.
Okay.
We talk about new technology, we talk about best practice for being inclusive in our workplace. We also run different events. So we were at our product fair earlier this summer, sharing some of the really cool innovations in accessibility.
Okay.
And then we get involved in nonprofits and charities. So that's coming up very soon here at Microsoft in October.
Cool. Now, when I think about accessibility, I mean, the first thing that comes to my mind is closed captioning. But what are some of the other, like you mentioned, really cool technologies evolving around accessibility? Can you talk about some of those that you saw?
There are some really cool things around accessibility. I really think accessibility is a form of innovation mm-hmm. and a really big frontier. So we actually demoed at a product fair a new technology being developed by Microsoft Research, which is where sign language, using the power of Windows Connect, can be converted into text.
Oh, wow.
And then text can be converted into sign language. It's in Chinese sign language right now, which is different to American sign language.
They have to make it complicated. They,
well, absolutely. It's a language.
Just be one.
It's a language. It's got a dialect. It's
wow.
got all that cool stuff. And then if you look at other modalities, there are different ways. I mean, the simplest form of accessibility is talking books, right? That's
okay.
where if you go back, if you look at it now, we have screen readers like Narrator on Windows 8 that will read through what's on your screen. Magnify, that pinch and zoom thing
yeah.
we do, that's accessibility. High contrast that flicks it when you're watching your email and reading your email while you're having lunch in the sun,
uh-huh.
that's accessibility. So actually, accessibility is becoming something that just gets embedded
yeah.
into how we work. And I love that, but it's a really cool form of innovation.
That's awesome. So let's dive into the fact that we offer the sign language classes to all Microsoft employees? What's the motivation there?
So it's all Microsoft Redmond right now. So these started several years ago, and they started as a need for us to think inclusively about our people and employees with disabilities. So when you have a person with deafness joining your group, we offer sign language to them, their group, their manager, their teams, to help encourage communication.
Mm-hmm.
And that's where it really started from, was helping groups to learn how to use just basic sign to be able to communicate better.
Yeah.
What we found, though, was that you learn so much more out of it. You learn how to think about disability and how it works and how to be just more aware of your surroundings, answer questions about it. We've all got questions.
Sure.
So it aided us in a lot, you know, far more ways. So we expanded it.
So when I think of learning a new skill, such as maybe learning how to play the guitar, this sounds very, very hard for me. And I imagine a year's worth of exhausting practice in order to be able to just do it a little bit. So can people really get enough of the basics in just a few classes of ASL?
you know, ASL is like, is a language like any other. The difference is that you're using your hands, but you're also using your expressions and your face. So Lindsay here, she's talking with me and telling me what you're saying.
Right.
She's not only using these beautiful things, but she's also using expressions on her face and how her shoulders are moving.
Right.
So it's a language, but it's just a bit different. We teach ASL 1 and 2 to our employees. That teaches some of the basics like finger spelling, ABC.
Okay.
And it will teach you a lot of those words that you use. An ASL tool helps you to put that into conversation and sentences. And then we have lots of external colleges around us that offer the more advanced courses.
Great, great.
And we also teach baby sign to a lot of our employees as well.
What's that?
So baby sign is a form of communication. It's simplified from ASL. But with my little one, when she was just 6 months old, she was telling me milk more.
Yeah.
She was telling me that she was like, no. She was almost doing this. She was saying, I'm all done. and so it's a real form of communication. So we expanded to that as well.
Oh, that's great.
To bring on a lot of our parents.
Oh, cool. Mm-hmm. Now, I noticed that the demand and excitement to get into the classes was high. In fact, the class I went to sign up for was full. So obviously, there's a lot of people around Microsoft that are interested in this. What has been the sort of response and feedback you've gotten from people who've finished the course?
We get feedback that's just phenomenal. People, as long as you can make the time and investment, you know, getting out of your daily work, getting to another building for a lunch, and it's 6 weeks, the feedback's just great because, it opens your eyes not just to a language, but it opens your eyes to a section of your community that is part of your community, and there are 1 billion people in the world with disabilities.
Yeah.
And knowing how to communicate, you'll learn some of those basics within this class. So we get really, really strong in the 90s feedback, and people are really dying for us to tell us where to take their skills next.
Right.
So those classes, we do a lot of PR around them just to keep it fresh, but those lists do get full.
Yes.
And then we slot people in as and when we can, and we keep them running throughout the fiscal year.
That's awesome. So what's next for you guys? What's next for the disability group here at Microsoft? And what would you like people at home to know and things that they can do to help?
I think, you know, from my perspective, the whole area of disability is just something that we need to be more aware of and educated about.
Mm-hmm.
It's an area that we shouldn't be shy of, we should embrace. So I think the more that anyone externally can educate themselves, there are lots of different classes that happen in sign language, in how to use different parts of technology, to how to think about this as a form of innovation, I mm-hmm. think is really, really key. For us, we're so excited. We have a sponsor of our disability group is now Satya Nadella.
Yeah.
He brings a ton of passion to this space. So we're focusing a lot on innovation. We're focusing a lot on accessibility and how we as a group can help add our expertise into
sure.
that forum.
Awesome. Well, mm-hmm. thank you so much. I know it's something that Channel 9 is going to be covering quite a bit of in the upcoming months because we're really looking to become more accessible through our videos.
Yay!
So hopefully that's a win-win, and we will see you next time. Thanks for coming.
Thank you.